Have you ever wondered how your doctor decides what type and how much medication to prescribe when treating you for a specific condition? There are so many different types of medications, with new ones being developed every day. How does he or she know what you need? A doctor has a lot to consider before prescribing a medication to make sure that they are safe and effective for you. Prior to choosing which medication is best, they consider several things, such as your specific symptoms, your medical history, your current medication use, if you have any allergies, and the possible side effects. Deciding how much medication you need is often based on such things as your age, weight, gender, ethnicity, blood tests results, and whether you smoke cigarettes or drink alcohol. This way of deciding how much is a pretty standard approach, or the one-size-fits-all model, and it doesn't really work for everyone. From one person to the next, the response to the exact same medication can be very different. This all depends on our genetic makeup and environment. Sometimes, instead of helping symptoms, a person may have a bad response to a medication that may cause serious side effects. Side effects are responsible for over 200,000 hospitalizations in Canada per year and are a leading cause of death. Imagine if a blood test could help reduce these adverse effects and save lives. Pharmacogenetics is the study of how genes can impact our individual responses to certain medications. Since our individual genetic makeup, or DNA, is unique, so are our responses to medications. Our DNA contains thousands of genes, which need to contain the right code or information to work properly. When the code in a particular gene is changed, this can alter how the gene works and, for example, impact how we may process certain medications. A gene change like this is called a variant. The vast majority of us have gene variants that can affect how our bodies respond to certain medications. These variants can determine how medications are taken in or absorbed, interact, break down, or are removed from our body. These differences in how medications are handled by our body impacts our response to them. Genetic testing can look at specific sets of genes to see if there are variants. Certain variants affect the ability of a medication to be broken down. For instance, if you break down or metabolize a medication at a slower speed, then your doctor may determine that the medication could be toxic to you, or perhaps you need less than someone who is a normal metabolizer. Likewise, if you are a fast metabolizer, you may need more medication. Another example is when a person is found to have a gene variant that may cause them to be hypersensitive to certain drugs. These issues could cause serious side effects. If testing reveals you are at a higher risk of having a side effect, then your doctor may choose a different medication to treat your symptoms. Currently, there are several different gene variants that, when tested, can assist your doctor in more accurately prescribing over 100 medications. These medications are used in treating psychiatric illnesses, heart disease, pain management, cancer, neurological problems, infectious diseases, autoimmune disorders, and conditions that affect the digestive tract. Pharmacogenetic testing is not available to everyone and is presently not a part of routine care, but we expect that this will change in the near future. Currently, SickKids is offering a clinical pharmacogenetics research pilot study, CPS pilot, to a limited number of children and adults. Thank you again for watching. If you want more information about the pharmacogenetic pilot study or are interested in viewing some of our other videos, just go to the Center for Genetic Medicine website to learn more.